Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with the chapter Two Stories About Flying. Okay, so the chapter is Two Stories About Flying. Okay, so very interesting stories. One is first of the small, you can say, bird, that is a seagull. Okay, seagull, how many of you have seen the seagull in the pictures? It's a sort of a bird. Okay, it used to dive in the sea in order to catch the fish. Means fish is its food. Okay, so wherever the seagull, it, you can say, it produces a loud noise, it sings. It means that the fishermen, they usually follow the sign of the seagull. It means that whenever seagull, they sing, they usually found a number of fishes there. So seagull, but here a very, you can say, soft as well as very tender part of the seagull is being presented, that how a young seagull who was trying to fly, but he was not, you can say, gathering his courage, and he's not able to fly, and ultimately what makes him fly. So how he is able to fly, this we are going to study in this chapter. So it is very interesting one, that how a seagull flies. And now see, you can see the unity in the family, that how the seagull's family, it has helped us in order to fly in the sky. Okay, so let us start with the chapter. So let me share with you first of all the page of the book which we are going to start. So the first one is about a young seagull. Okay, the first flight. 1 minute please. So just a moment please. Let me share with you the page. Yes. So here is the page, the first one. Students are still entering. I don't know why they are entering late. So his first flight, it is on the basis of this chapter. The name of the book is The First Flight. So very beautiful, very heart-touching chapter. So let us start with the chapter, reading of the chapter. Now, in this case, a young seagull who is trying to fly. And ultimately, who helps the seagull to fly? He was not eating any food. He was just behaving that nobody is looking at him. But still, what happened that the seagull, his mother, she has dropped the food near its mouth so that he can catch the food. But what she did, in spite of throwing it in its beak, she has thrown it into the sea, and then the flight started. So let us start with the chapter. Students are still entering. So, the young seagull was alone on his ledge. His two brothers and sisters. Ledge is, you can say, it is a narrow platform. Okay, which is a sort of a shell. Okay, so a young seagull was alone on his ledge. His two brothers and sisters had already flown away the day before. He had been afraid to fly with them. So the young seagull, he was alone sitting on the ledge, but he was afraid to fly. His other brothers and sisters, they have flown along with him. Okay, they have flown before him the yesterday. It means the day before yesterday. But he was so afraid that he was not able to make his flight. Somehow, when he had taken a little run forwards to the brink, brink means to the edge of the ledge, and attempted to flap his wings, he became afraid. But whenever he's trying to go to the edge of the, ledge, he's trying to make his flight. But every time he's going, he's so afraid that he always comes back. The great expanse means vast area. The great expanse of sea stretched down beneath, and it was such a long way down, miles down. So he was thinking that it is really very harmful for him if he would fly, because he would ultimately fall into the sea, because there was a large area of sea in front of him. And he was thinking that his wings would not support him. So this is the reason why he was thinking that he would not be able to fly. His wings would not support him. So he bent his head and ran away back to the little hole under the ledge where he slept at night. So again and again he was trying. But again, after trying, when he thought that his wings would not support him, he was coming back again to his little hole which was on the side of the ledge, and he spent his whole night there. even when each of his brothers and his little sister, whose wings were far shorter than his own, ran to the brink, flapped their wings and flew away, he failed to muster up courage. Muster up courage means gather. Muster up courage to take that plunge. Plunge means that dive. That dive. Okay? So plunge, which appeared to him so desperate. So every time he has seen that his younger brother and sister, whose wings are even smaller than his, they have not developed so as his wings were. They have gone to the ledge and they were flapping. Flapping means movement, up and downward movement of the wings. They were flapping their wings and they flew away. Looking at them, he was thinking again and again that he should go and make a flight. But what is happening? He was not able to muster up his courage. He was not able to gather up his courage to make that dive into the sea, into the air. So he thought that his wings would not support him. His father and mother had come around calling to him shrilly, unbraiding him. Unbraiding means to scold him. Okay, unbraiding him means to scold him. Note down the meaning side by side, please. Yes. Calling him shrilly means, they were also passing some remarks to her, calling him that he is very, you can say, coward, upbraiding him, scolding him, threatening to let him starve on his ledge unless he flew away. And they were also threatening him that they would let him starve on the ledge. They would not give him any food on the ledge and if he won't flew away. But for the life of him, he could not move. But he was not having any, you can say, he was not at all trying to move and trying to fly. That was 24 hours ago. Since then, nobody had come near him. So this was 24 hours ago. After that, his brothers and sisters, along with his mother and father, they have left the ledge. They have moved to a different place. And since those 24 hours, he was all alone on the ledge. Nobody had come near him. Nobody had come even to ask for him whether he has eaten food or not. The day before, all day long, he had waited, his parents flying. He has watched his parents flying about with his brothers and sisters, performing them in the art of flight, teaching them how to skim the waves. Skim means to slightly, you can say, swim over the waves of water, and how to dive for fish. So he was watching from the ledge that his brothers, and sisters, they were learning from their parents, from their father, and the father was telling them the tact, how they can fly, how they can make a flight, and teaching them how they can also skim the waves. Skim the waves means to slightly move over the waves. How they can skim the waves, and ultimately they were just learning. Okay, they were just learning that how they can skim the waves. And he had in fact seen his older brother catch his first herring. Herring is a sort of fish. He has seen his older brother also, that he has catched his first fish. This is because his father has told him how to dive into the water and catch the fish and devour it. Devour means eat it. It is a synonym of eating. Because for seagulls, fish is the food. So this is the reason his father was teaching this young seagulls that how to catch the fish and eat it. And ultimately they have eaten it. And raising a proud cackle. Cackle is the sound produced, okay? Sound produced by the bird. And all the morning, the whole family had walked about on the big plateau midway down the opposite cliff, taunting him with his scarred eyes. So the family has moved to a nearby plateau in the sea, okay? Small area of land near the sea. And ultimately, they were taunting him from there, from that plateau, that he is not trying to fly. Actually, they wanted good of him. They wanted that he should also fly. The sun was now ascending the sky, blazing on his ledge that faced the south. He felt the heat because he had not eaten since the previous nightfall. So now in the morning, the sun was rising in the sky. It was blazing. It was shining on his ledge. And because it was facing south, he was feeling the heat, but he had not eaten anything. Since the previous night, he has not eaten anything and he was not having anything to eat. He stopped slowly out to the brink of the ledge and standing on one leg with the other leg hidden under his wing, he closed one eye then the other and pretended to be falling asleep. So see how mischievous he is. he has just stood on his one leg and hiding his another leg on the under his wing, and he was trying that he is going to fall. So that why he is doing this? He is doing this so that he is doing that so that his parents would, you can say, take hold of the situation. They will see that he is about to fall and they will come and save him. But ultimately, what will happen? No, they won't come. Still, they look, no notice of him. They were not paying any attention because it is not the love. It means that one should come out of this comfort zone. Okay, one should come out of his or her fears in order to achieve success. It is only just because of that a person can achieve success. He saw his two brothers and his sister lying on the plateau, dozing with their head. Dozing means sleeping. With their heads sunk into their necks. He has seen that his other two brothers and sisters, you must have seen that how the birds, they take rest. How they take rest? That is, they sunk their heads inside their necks, okay, inside their wings, and they close their eyes. So this is the way of sleeping the birds. And as he has seen his, you can say, two brothers and sisters, they were dozing with their heads sink into their necks. His father was preening the feathers on his white back. Preening means to clean, okay, to remove the excess and unwanted ones. His father was trying to clean the feathers on his white back. Only his mother was looking at him. You know that mother's love is the greatest love. Mother was looking at him. She was standing on a little high hump on the plateau. Her white breast thrust forward. She was standing on the hump, means on the slightly raised platform of the plateau. Her white breast, that is the white color of her breast, it was moving forward and now and again. So now and again, she tore at a piece of fish that lay at her feet and then scraped each side of her beak on the rock. So what she was doing, she was, you can say, taking that small piece of fish that was lying near her foot, and she was, after eating that, she was scraping. She was, you can say, just rubbing her beak on the rock in order to clean it of the extra flesh. The sight of the food maddened him. So because the seagull, he has not eaten anything, so the sight of the food, it had altogether maddened him. He wanted food at any cost and anyhow he wanted. But he did not have courage to fly and take it from his mother. And mother was just waiting how he can come and fly. The sight of the food maddened him. How he loved to tear food that way, scraping his beak now and again to wet it. Okay, wet it means to sharpen it. Wet means to sharpen it. So he was thinking that how he loved food to eat in this manner, and how he is always, you can say, sharpening his, you can say, how he is sharpening his beak now and again. He loved that, and he wanted to come out of that, right? So ga 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 means this is the sound produced by the seagull. Ga ga ga, he cried, begging her to bring him some food. Gull, she screamed back derisively means in a stupid manner. So she was producing that sound, and ultimately again she in return also produced the same sound, but in a stupid manner, because she never wanted that she should help, that what she should do, that she should help the seagull to come out of it. Okay, so his mother had picked up a piece of the fish and was flying across to him with it. So his mother, she was trying to pick that piece of fish and she was flying towards it. He leaned out eagerly. So he knew that my mother is coming towards me. So what he did, he leaned in front of the ledge so that he could catch hold of the, you can say, fish that his mother is going to give him. So tapping the rock with his feet, trying to get nearer to her as she flew across. But when she was just opposite him, she halted. She stopped. Her wings, they were motionless. The piece of fish in her beak, almost within the reach of his beak. He waited a moment in surprise, wondering why she did not come nearer. And then, maddened by hunger, he dived at the fish. So you can see very well, the mother, she has brought a piece of fish. She did not give it to him. In spite of throwing it in the beak of this young seagull, she has thrown it into the sea. and young seagull, he had no other option as he was maddened with hunger. So what he did, he dived for that piece of fish into the sea. So with a loud scream, he produced a loud sound. He fell outwards and downwards into space. You can very well imagine, you can see great imagery is used by the poet through his words, that he was moving up and downwards into the space. Then a monstrous terror seized him. He was terror stricken. He was afraid. Okay. So this terror, it was coming to him like a monster. But his heart, it stood still. But his heart was still. He could hear nothing, but it only lasted a minute. He was not able to hear anything around because his mind, it was completely, you can say, it was completely caught hold of that fear. He could hear nothing and he could listen nothing around him, but it only terror and terror that he was feeling. The next moment he felt his wings spread outwards, but the next moment immediately, means spontaneously, without any effort, his wings moved outwards. Then the wind rushed against his breast feathers and then under his stomach and against his wings. It means he can feel the movement of the wind touching his, you can say, feathers as well as stomach. He could feel the tips of the wings cutting through the air, and he was feeling that his wings were cutting the air also. It means he has learned to fly. He could feel the tips of wings. He was not falling headlong now. He was soaring gradually. Soaring means rising, flying downwards and outwards. He was no longer afraid, but now he has learned, in spite of going down into the sea, he was soaring, he was rising high above in the sky. He has learned now how to fly, and he just felt a bit dizzy, little bit of dizziness, you can say sleepy feeling, uncomfortable feeling he had, but that was no longer, he was no longer afraid. Then he flapped his wings. Then the next moment he started movement up and downward, movement of his wings. This helped the bird to fly. And once he soared upwards, ga ga ga, this sound, and his mother swooped, means immediately with fast movement, she passed across him, her wings making a loud noise. And her mother, when she passed, the wings were also making a loud noise. And he answered her with another scream. Then his father flew over him screaming. So then his father also accompanied them. They were happy that their young seagull, who was afraid of flying, now he has learned how to fly. Then he saw his two brothers and his sister flying around him, coveting and banking and soaring and diving. Coveting means making round movements, okay? Right? So they were moving and they were soaring and they were making flight around him. So this is how the seagull has learned how to fly. It means he was afraid to fly, but later on what has happened, that he himself has died just after a piece of food, and then ultimately by flapping his wings, he has come to know how to fly. Then he completely forgot that he had not always been able to fly and commended himself to die and soar and curve, shrieking shrilly. So then he forgot about that time, that when he was afraid to fly. Now he himself has learned how to fly, how to carry his flight. Okay. So in this manner, the young seagull, he has, you can say, learned how to fly, and he has made his first fly. He was near the sea now, flying straight over it, facing straight out over the ocean. He saw a vast green sea beneath him with little ridges moving over it, and he turned his beak sideways and cawed amusedly. So he was in the sea, near the sea, he was flying over it, and ultimately green sea was under him. He can look now, he is making a perfect flight in the sky. He's not able to afraid now, and he turned his beak sideways in order to produce a sound in response to the shrieking sound, to the shrill sound of his brothers and sisters. His parents and his brothers and sister had landed on this green flooring ahead of him. Green flooring means that is sea. They have landed on the sea. You know, some of the birds, they can swim over the sea. So they have landed on the sea, but now he did not know how to land. They were beckoning to him, calling shrilly. They were again pushing them, calling him, okay, shrilly, that he's caught. He dropped his legs to stand on the green sea. So now, gathering up his courage, he stood on the sea, that whether he would dive or not. His leg sank into it. His leg little bit sank into the water. He screamed with fright. He produced a loud noise of terror and attempted to rise again, flapping his wings. And he again, you can say, he again has risen up and again started flapping his wings in order to balance himself on the sea. So what happened that he was able to balance himself, and but he was tired and weak with hunger and he could not rise. But this time what has happened that he was weak with hunger. Okay, so why he was weak with hunger? Because he has eaten, he has not eaten anything, because that, you can say, that piece of fish that he was trying to catch, he was not able to catch it. Okay, he was not able to catch it and he was feeling, you can say, and he can, you can say, he cannot be able to balance himself, but he was tired and weak with hunger. He could not rise and exhausted by the strange exercise. But at this time, what has happened that he was tired of this exercise of movement. He was just thinking that what would happen of him if he would not be able to stand and he would not be able to you can say, skim the waves. His feet sank into the green sea, but then his belly touched it. And he sank no farther. So his, you can see his feet little bit sank, but his belly means his, you can say, stomach area, it touched the water, but he was not able to sink before. It means he has maintained his balance. He was floating on it and around him, his family was screaming, praising him, and the beaks were offering the scraps of dogfish, and he made his first flight. So his family was also along with him swimming over that green water. They were giving him small pieces of dogfish and they were celebrating his first flight. And this is how this young seagull, he has learned how to make his first flight. Very interesting, very touching. I love this character of seagull. You can imagine, you must have seen animated movies in which small kiwis, small birds, how they are behaving. The same one is that, the seagull. Okay, so how he is behaving, he was trying to catch the attention of the family members so that they can give him food. But the parents, they know that he should do it on his own. He must have to do it on his own because it is not the help or the aid that is being provided by the parents. But ultimately what it is, it is ultimately one's courage that is needed to achieve success. And for Seagull, what is his success? His success is to make his first flight that was he afraid of. So the writer, he is delivering us the message that in order to achieve success, we have to come out of our comfort zones. Comfort zones, like we have to come out of our, you can say, comfortable area of our thoughts. We should stand against those odd times. We should stand against difficulties in order to achieve success. So one can achieve success only by coming out of his, you can say, terror as well as fear. So this is all about this short story, that is his first flight. And this is the reason why the name of the book is First Flight. The next story is about an aeroplane that the pilot was flying the aeroplane in the sky. His aeroplane, it was struck in a storm. But what happened? So when it was struck in the storm, something, you can say, supernatural happened and saved his aeroplane. How he was saved, that was completely a mystery that we will reach tomorrow. So before that, let us discuss the question answers of this chapter that is being displayed on your screen, thinking about the text. So first question is, why was the young seagull afraid to fly? Do you think all young birds are afraid to make their first flight? Are some birds more timid? Timid means weak than others. Do you think a human baby also finds it a challenge to take his first step? Yes, first of all, why the seagull? The main question is why the seagull was afraid. Okay, the young seagull was afraid to fly because the young seagull was thinking that his wings would not support him. He was terror-stricken. He was not able to muster up his courage in order to make his first flight. He was afraid that if he would make a dive into the air, into the sky, he would definitely fall into the green water of the sea. And it is just because of this reason that he was not able to fly, although his younger brother and sisters, their wings, they have not so developed, they have made their first flight. So, of course, like that, the human beings, the children of human beings or the babies of human beings, they are also afraid. to make their, you can say, first step, because it is really a challenge for them. But sometimes you must have seen that how a baby is taking first step on his own. Nobody is telling him. It is just the motor development. Okay, it is the development of the limbs of the babies. Okay, that ultimately has made it. Similarly, in this, you can say, story also, the young seagull who was not able to fly, later on, what has happened? It was just his spontaneous flight into the sky. And when he started flapping his wings, he has come to know how to make his first flight. So next, second question, the sight of the food maddened him. What does this suggest? What compelled the young seagull to finally fly? The sight of food maddened him. What it means? It means that for the complete previous day, for the past 24 hours, the young seagull, he has not eaten anything. As he has not eaten anything, so he was maddened with hunger. He's mad to eat the piece of dogfish and ultimately to wet his beak. Wet means to sharpen his beak on the sides of the rock. So this suggests that he was very hungry as he has not eaten anything for the past 24 hours. And what compelled the young seagull to finally fly? Finally, this sight of food, when his mother has brought a small piece of dogfish, and she has thrown it into the sea in spite of his, you can say, beak. So this sight maddened him, and he was able to catch hold of it, and he has finally made his first dive into the sea. Okay, I hope that it is clear. If it is clear, just raise up your, put your thumbs up and show me. Okay, right, fine. So next is, they were beckoning to him, calling him shrilly. Why did the seagull's father and mother threaten him and cajole? Cajole, he means to, you can say, passing some, you can say, insulting remarks, to insult him. Why they were trying? So that he could rise up, he could make up his mind to fly, because earlier he was afraid. So this is the reason his father and other brothers and sisters, they were also calling him shrilly. They were also cajoling him. They were also upbraiding him. Have you ever seen a similar experience with your parents encourages you to do? Yes, this is completely based on your personal experience. You can write it on your own. So the fifth question is also based upon your personal experience. So these three questions you have to do in your notebook. Tomorrow I will also provide you some extra questions for this. Okay. So I hope that you have very well understood the chapter. Okay. So now let us start for the attendance. Okay. So any doubt in this chapter, if you have any doubt, you can raise up your hands. Or is it clear? If it is clear, just put your thumbs up to make me sure that you have learned, you have understood the chapter. Okay, right. So the chapter is really very nice. I really like this chapter, that how seagull he is trying to move, and ultimately how he is trying to, you can say, fly. And ultimately it is that upbraiding and that scolding by his parents that made him to take his first flight. So that's all for today, and tomorrow we will continue with the next one. Okay.